Coming up on Pierce County News.
People, including myself, need it.
New changes in cuts to bus service. Long lines for concealed pistol licenses. And what has the SWAT team in Puyallup? Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radall. It looks like Pierce Transit won't have to eliminate all of its weekend bus service, but there will still be steep cuts. It was standing room only at the Pierce Transit Board of Commissioners meeting. Bus riders lined up to give their input on the proposed cuts to weekend bus service.
It will eliminate a lot of people going to work, a lot of people going to church services, and a lot of people just generally getting out of the house.
Last month, the Pierce Transit Board voted to completely eliminate weekend service. They said the move was needed after voters rejected a sales tax increase last year. Since that vote, riders have been up in arms.
We are not serve Pierce Transit. Pierce Transit should serve the people. That's the point.
Pierce Transit has been able to find new revenue, including federal grants, tax credits, and reworking the capital budget. This week, the board voted to revise the weekend cuts.
Today, for example, Pierce Transit operates 40,000 hours a year on Saturdays. This service, it will, with this plan, with this revised plan, it will be 17,000 hours. So you're talking about more than a 50% cut in Saturday service, but at least it's something.
Under the new plan, Sunday service will also be cut by more than 50%, and there will be no holiday service. The changes are scheduled to take effect at the end of September. There are still several more public meetings on the issue in March. From transportation to public safety and growing the economy, Pierce County Executive Pat McCarthy has some big plans for the next 4 years. McCarthy is just starting her second term as Pierce County Executive, but she's already taking on some big ticket items. Transportation is at the top of the list.
The completion of 167 is so critically important to our port and to the movement of freight, and we're very trade dependent county and having a very robust port, so we need to make sure that we have the right infrastructure in place.
Pierce County has more than 80 businesses, big and small, that help supply and support the aerospace industry. The county hosted its first aerospace summit last year, and there will be more to come.
I'm very supportive of making sure that we retain and recruit businesses in the aerospace sector, because it's a growth industry. It will be growing for years to come, and that's good for Pierce County.
McCarthy is also working on an initiative to revitalize the farming industry, and she's busy planning for a successful U.S. Open in 2015. And with the economic forecast for the county looking bright, she's ready to keep the momentum going.
For the next 4 years, it's a matter of making sure we keep moving forward and making this community a better place to live and to work and to play.
Executive Pat McCarthy joined other government leaders at a forum in Tacoma to talk about the future of transportation in our state. Megan Hutton looks at what it could mean for your pocketbook.
I think people are getting it because they're stuck in traffic.
Fixing and paying for our future transportation system was the hot topic at a forum of government leaders from Pierce, King, and Snohomish counties. Improving congestion is what citizens and businesses both want to see.
70% of the freight that comes through the Port of Tacoma and the Port of Seattle and the Port of Everett goes someplace else. If they can't move that freight once they get it to dock, they aren't going to bring it through here. They're going to take it someplace else. And in an economy where 40% of our jobs are dependent on trade, that's really, really important.
For that reason, Pierce County wants to see Highway 167 finished from Puyallup to Tacoma. Executive Pat McCarthy, who also chairs Sound Transit, says we are not funding transportation adequately to fix the problems.
Whether we toll ourselves, whether we get federal funding, whether we tax ourselves on more gas tax, however we're going to put that package together, we are going to need more dollars.
But in the future, how we pay for transportation could be very different. Right now, it's a gas tax. But what if we paid for state roads like we pay a monthly cell phone bill?
We need to start thinking about transportation the way we think about sewage, which is to say it's a utility. And it's a utility that has to be managed for the service area, not for the jurisdiction.
The panelists say they're seeing better regional planning since the creation of groups like the Puget Sound Regional Council. All eyes will be on the state transportation budget as it develops over the next few months. Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.
The number of people wanting to get a concealed pistol license is setting records in Pierce County, with more than 800 applications already in the month of February. In the shadow of the county city building on Tacoma Avenue, they wait in line, coffee in hand, before 8 in the morning.
Because I ride a motorcycle, so I'd like the added protection there for the people that don't pay attention to us bike riders.
I like to go shoot with my husband. It's something he likes to do. And in order to have a gun in the back of my car to go shoot with him, I have to have a concealed permit.
When the doors open at 8:30, the waiting area is full. At South Sound 911, formerly known as LISA, they'll process around 100 concealed pistol licenses in one day. Back in October, the average was 50. Russell Barber says the surge in new applications is caused by many things, including gun laws, mass shootings, and an election year.
About 60% roughly were new, and the rest were renewals. And so the numbers just continue to climb.
Staff are making efficiencies behind the scenes to move people through faster, but it can still take 1 to 3 hours for the application and fingerprinting process.
Now we've gone from one window 4 days a week to two windows 5 days a week. So the waits are a lot better than they used to be.
To avoid having your application denied or delayed, it's important to know a few things. If you've had your rights restored after a previous conviction, be sure to bring that paperwork with you. Restraining orders, domestic violence offenses, and juvenile records can prevent you from getting a CPL.
In Washington State, if you have pled guilty or a finding of guilt has been entered into record, that's a conviction. And it doesn't matter later if you had a dismissal, you serve a period of probation or suspension, it's still a conviction by state law. And if the charge was a prohibitive charge, meaning a felony or certain domestic violence misdemeanors, that is going to preclude you from getting a firearm.
A concealed pistol license is good for 5 years and costs between $32 and $52. South Sound 911 is open Monday through Friday. Call 253-798-7441 with questions. If understanding your Social Security benefits is confusing, there is a new online tool to help. Joining me today is Kirk Larson. He is with the Social Security Administration. Kirk, let's talk about this new feature on your website called My Social Security Account.
Yes, just as you described, there's a new feature on our website at www.socialsecurity.gov where you can go in and you can get an online benefit statement. So you can see what your future benefits are going to be for retirement, survivors, disability benefits, and you can also review your work history. You can see how much money you made year by year.
So does this mean that we won't be getting that piece that we're used to getting in the mail that had all this information?
Yes, for many years we've sent out a Social Security statement to all working individuals, and you've probably gotten several of those over the years. This online statement is now replacing that. So we will not be sending that out in the mail anymore. And one of the main reasons we did that is it cost us about $60 million a year to send that form out to all working individuals. So this is a big cost savings to the Social Security Administration and to us as the American people. And now you'll be able to get that statement anytime that you want. Just go right online and you'll be able to review it.
So what about people who are already receiving benefits? Do they still need to set up this account online?
Yes. Now, while there's many benefits, if you're not getting benefits yet, using this will help you see what your future benefits are going to be and be able to let you review your work history. If you are getting benefits, still having this is very important. More and more of what Social Security is doing is moving online. So if you want to be able to change your address, change your phone number, change your direct deposit, get a benefit verification letter. If you were, let's say, renting an apartment and you needed verification of what your benefits were, you'd be able to get that all right online. And also, we expect to expand this to include additional features. So if you wanted to get information to see what your payment history had been, or to get replacement Medicare cards, or other different things with Social Security, rather than going into an office or calling our 800 number, which you'll still be able to do, you could do this all from the comfort of your own home whenever you wanted to make the changes. So it's a great feature for people that haven't started getting benefits. And if you are on benefits, it'll be a big time savings and allow you to have control over your records.
On another note, I understand there's initiatives starting on March 1st in regards to how people will be getting their payments.
That's correct. For a number of years, for the last 2 years actually, if you've started new benefits, if you started Social Security benefits, you were required to set up direct deposit. However, many people before that hadn't set up direct deposit. And today, about 4 or 5% of people still get paper checks. Well, starting March 1st, the Treasury Department, who controls all federal payments, are requiring individuals to have direct deposit or to get something called Direct Express, which is a debit card issued by the Treasury Department. And you'd be able to use that just like a regular debit card. If you wanted to get cash out at an ATM machine, you could do that. Or if you wanted to use it at a store, you'd be able to do that. So come March 1st, that small number of people that are still getting paper checks will be required to change over to receiving either direct deposit to a bank account or obtaining a Direct Express debit card.
So a lot of changes in the works. Well, thanks for coming in and talking to us about those.
Thank you for having me.
Two Pierce County school districts asked voters to approve bond measures in this week's special election, but only one district is celebrating. Voters in Tacoma said yes to a $500 million bond measure. The bond will pay for 14 new or remodeled schools and help pay for smaller projects at more than 50 schools. It's been more than 10 years since voters in Tacoma approved a major school construction bond measure. The Puyallup School District's $279.6 million bond measure came close but did not pass. It fell short of the 60% supermajority needed to move forward. The last school bond measure that Puyallup voters approved was 9 years ago. Coming up next, find out why residential flooding is bringing out the SWAT team in Puyallup. We're back in just 60 seconds.
Pierce County has an air quality problem. During the wintertime, more than half of the pollution in Pierce County comes from indoor wood burning. That's a lot of smoke polluting the air, and that's not okay. In fact, that's more than transportation and industry combined. It's not good for the health of our community or your family. Err on the safe side. Find out when it's okay to burn and learn about healthier alternatives. Get more information today. Visit airsafepiercecounty.org.
A program to help flooded out homeowners in Pierce County is also helping law enforcement. We were there when the SWAT team stormed one Pierce County home.
Police! Sanctuary! Open the door!
What looked like a full-blown SWAT operation in the Riverside neighborhood of Pierce County was really a tactical training exercise for the Tacoma Police Department's SWAT team.
They get a day of training, and then we come in and demolish the house afterwards.
It's all part of Pierce County's flood buyout program. The county uses FEMA grant money to buy flood-prone houses like this from willing sellers. Then they let nonprofits like Habitat for Humanity salvage appliances and materials and let police and fire use the houses for training.
Most of the money we've used to acquire these homes is federal dollars, with about 12% coming from the county.
This Puyallup home near River Road is in a low-lying community built before the county ever had flood hazard maps. From the front, it's hard to tell anything could be wrong with the house, but a closer look shows rings of debris from past floods. Even raising the home couldn't protect it. The basement is full of water.
All told, we've acquired about 15 homes right now in this community, and in the long term are hoping to use some of this land for a habitat mitigation site for some of our larger flood control projects.
Smelt says there's a long list of homeowners in flood zones who would like to sell their homes, but patience can pay off. Taxpayers benefit from these buyouts by not spending millions on other flood fixes. And being able to use the home for training exercises like this,
Police Sanctuary, open the door!
Is just another added bonus
please
of the program. Up next, get ready for a fun run in the shadow of Mount Rainier. But first, here's some dates for your calendar. If you're a senior in Buckley or the Key Peninsula and don't have dental insurance, you may qualify to get your teeth cleaned for free. Pierce County Community Connections Aging and Disability Resources is screening seniors now, and there are several openings available. For more information and to see if you qualify, give the ADRC a call at 253-798-4600. Here's a chance to learn how to turn your waste into something productive. Pierce County Public Works and Utilities is offering free classes on composting. The first class is February 28th at the Environmental Services Building in University Place, but there will be several more throughout the spring. Pre-registration is required. For more information, go to piercecountywa.org/composting. This week, Kyle Wintermute is already warming up for the big event. Hi, Kyle.
Hi, Heather. Hey, are you well on your way to meeting those goals for a healthier you in 2013? Then take the next step, or jog, or run, to this year's 2013 Foothills Dash. This annual Fun Run Walk dashes along the Foothills Trail in Orting. The race includes awesome views of Mount Rainier, picturesque farmlands, and of course, the quaint town of Orting. The race includes a 5 and 10K course and 1 mile youth run. Save some money and pre-register before February 21st, and don't forget to purchase a t-shirt. Mark your calendar for Saturday, March 9th, and keep up your commitment to participate in lots of healthy activities this year. Have you ever wanted to learn how to play a musical instrument? It's said that those who play music develop stronger concentration and memory, enhance your coordination, and might even improve your math skills. There's no better time than now to take that chance and learn something new. The guitar classes held at Sprinker Recreation Center will teach you the basics with introductory note reading, simple chords, and playing some basic songs. So put down the Guitar Hero and try the real deal. Just think, this could be the beginning of a whole new you. Call or go online for more information. Staying healthy isn't a race, it's a way of life. And Pierce County Parks and Recreation is here to help you find that healthier life you're looking for. I'm Kyle Wintermute for Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather. See you at the race.
Sounds like fun. Thanks, Kyle. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you won't find anywhere else. If you'd like to watch past Pierce County news shows, just go to our website at piercecountytv.org, click on the show, and scroll down for a link to the archives. I'm Heather Radel. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.